You have been somewhat on the outside watching the last few years of developments in the mining sector. It's been a turbulent time. It's never very dull in the sector anyway. And I wondered if you could give us your views on, it'll have to be the majors, but what the majors have done well while you've been looking on and not participating, and what they've done badly.
I mean, clearly what the majors have done, a pretty traumatic few years, is address their fundamental sort of cost base. And I think all of them have done fantastic work in really cutting out significant costs on the operational base and making themselves more resilient as a result of doing that. And I've seen, you know, some organizations which have really been in pretty precarious positions, and you would have thought at points in time that they had nowhere to go. Essentially, because of this very focused thing on getting the operations done and essentially concentrating on the stuff which you can actually do, as opposed to, you know, and almost having bigger visions, but nevertheless concentrating on seeing incrementally every day how they can improve things, have actually come through and set themselves in a very, very credible position. The Anglo American, I think, is a great example of that. That a few years ago, Anglo American was in a really bad shape and in a really bad position, whereas today, I think, is an entirely different position. And this strong concentration that the team there, led by Mark, has had, I think, has paid enormous dividends, to use them as just one example. So I think that has been a very, very good exercise of focused management by the industry. And as a result of that, they because of their retardation of the investment programs, and we'll come back to that now, they've been able to return significant amounts of cash in the form of dividends and capital returns to shareholders, and therefore they've sort of satisfied the needs of the investment community. But therein lies, I think, their biggest challenge going forward. That they have not, and boards of directors and management teams generally have not focused on this very simple proposition that mining companies, every single day they take something out of the ground, that value disappears forever. And unless you do something to replace that value, you are going to end up withering and dying. And we have many good examples in South Africa of grand and great mining companies. Grand Mines, for instance, for many years ago, those who are old enough will remember, being a great example. It was once the biggest mining company in the world. That doesn't exist because of a lack of investment in rebuilding and recreating value. And some value creation can come about by lowering your cost base, more grey becomes payable, more ore becomes payable in the ground. But most of it comes from ongoing investments and increasing your optionality. So the ability to create value depends on the options that you have within your portfolio, and to recognize when those options should be tackled. And I fear that this very focused approach on returning cash to shareholders in the form of dividends and capital returns has not, in fact, taken into account the need to sufficiently reinvest. And so they have not created new optionality. And for most mining companies, that means that they will, that unless they do something, their NPV going forward is just simply going to show a declining trend. And ultimately, that will reflect itself in the share price, because the present value of the future cash flows ultimately will decline. And I think that's a challenge. And the challenge is there because for them to change that course of action, they need to convince investors that that's something that they should be doing. And I just think that the education, the comms, the almost the propaganda in a very positive sense, that mining executives have to engage with the investors on a continuous basis has been allowed to die away. And so there is quite a gulf now between the imperatives of mining companies to continue to create and generate value and the long-term investments that are required for that versus the expectations of the investor community. And I think there is a big challenge there and a big gulf that needs to be bridged.